But I know that even today, the Almighty God will permanently settle someone. And I am one of those people. Who can remind us of our team, the general team? Very good. The God that answers prayer. The day one topic. The starting point. The day two topic. Prepare to confront. Day three topic. Alignment of. Yeah, very good. Even though I have seen you reading your book, God bless you. Alignment of confession. Now today, we are going to be discussing something also powerful. All the things that God has been teaching us, they are in line with Him answering our prayers. There is a positioning you need to attain or achieve for you to easily get your prayer answered. Before we were talking about, we have to remove sins and disobedience, that those are prayer or answer to prayer blocker. But I say that it's not that my ears have been blocked or my hand weak that I cannot reach out and help you. But the sin and iniquity of people have separated it from them. So once we can remove that, it will be easy for our prayers to be answered or for us to receive our prayer. Another thing is that we talk about prepare to confront. Many times we have the power of God in our lives, but we are too scared to confront the enemy, thinking that the power of the enemy, they have greater power. They don't have. One of the things that the devil does or uses is intimidation or fear. That's why most of the places that they call satanic places that people consult, they put scary things there. So that by the time you are in, they humble you when you are in. They make sure that their horse is very short. You must bend down by force. So that by the time you bend down, you are hearing different sound. And you see the head of skeleton rolling like this. And you scary things. You will just see that when you even come outside spiritual and just intelligently say, why? You see that all this to intimidate you and to arrest your attention. But in God's presence, it does not need no material power. Everything will be simple. But the greatness of the power will be made manifest. So we said that we should not be afraid to confront the enemy. And I pray that God will help us in Jesus' name. Yesterday we talked about aligning our confession. That sometimes we pray, but we'll be speaking some other things, maybe in frustration or trying to belong. And those things will not be negating the effectiveness of the prayer that we pray. And we'll have forgotten what we have said. I will not come again. Hey God, what's happening now? God is trying to tell us that align. When you align, you will see the way your prayers will be answered. And I pray that the Almighty God will respond to every desire of our heart quickly this year in the name of Jesus. Amen. Then this day number four, we are going to talk about, the theme is riding on the prophetic leverage. Riding on prophetic leverage. When we are talking about prophetic leverage, whether some people want to believe it or not, there are some people God has invested or endowed with His power, that when they release prayer on somebody's behalf, God will hear. In the book of Matthew chapter 14, 19 to 21, Matthew 14, 19 to 21, you will read a popular account of Jesus Christ preaching to some people, and after a while, they were weary, and they had limited supply of bread and fishes. But something happened that we are going to be bringing out here for you to really see that there are some set of people that God honors or God does miraculous things to their hands. And he commanded the multitude to sit down on the grass and took the 5 loaves and the 2 fishes. And looking up to heaven, he blessed and broke and gave the loaves to who? To his disciples. And the disciples to who? To the multitude. 20. And they did all eat and were filled. And they took up of the fragments that remained. How many baskets? 5 baskets full. 21. And they that had eaten were about how many? 5,000 men, besides women and children. God did special works through the hands of his disciples. I have read this portion many times until the particular time that God opened my understanding to what actually happened there. When they know Jesus Christ, this is just what we have. And he said, the disciples said they were doubtful that let's send them away so that let them go and buy. He said, what do we have? He said, 5 loaves, just a little boy that has and fishes. Okay, bring. He blessed and broke, and the Bible said that I gave to the disciple. The miracle did not happen when he was giving it to the disciple. They now said the disciple gave to the multitude. I can imagine half bread that had been broken to one of the disciples, go and share it. I can imagine as he was cutting it, the thing was not reducing. Cutting it, the thing. And he said that 5,000 men and minor. So the miracle did not happen in the hand of Jesus Christ. But he has blessed it. He said, I've empowered you that as you be releasing it, there will be great manifestation. In life, there are some sets of people that God chooses and he endows with some powers. And when they say amen to your prayer, or they tell you, okay, let it be to you as you have asked God. God honors their word. In the book of Acts chapter, 19, Acts chapter 19, maybe 11 and 12, talking about Paul, the Bible said that God wrought special miracles. And God wrought special miracles by who? The hand of Paul. 12. So that from his body were brought unto the sick handkerchiefs of Ephraim, and the diseases departed from them, and the evil spirit went out of them. God wrought special miracle by the hand of God. First off, who wrought the special miracle?
God.
Beautiful. Who did God use, or whose hand did God use to do the miracle? God. In life, there are some people. It will not really be them. It's foolish men of God that think that whenever God uses them to do things, it is them. God blesses them for using it, but it's actually God using them. There are some people God will use. Their words are authority because they have been empowered by God to do that. I remember some time ago, when we were doing our Christmas carol, those days we used to use candlelight, whenever it gets to silent night time. It's not now that we are using battery-powered lighting. Things have changed. But that time, it's candle that we'll be using. But you notice something. Everybody will be giving candle and the light will be put off. Then I will be giving match box or maybe lighter. I will strike the match or put or light my own candle and I will give to the ministers. the minister in turn will give to some people, and that very in a short while the whole place will be well lit. If I ask somebody who got yours lit, the correct thing would be that I passed it, because whoever you collected did not have the lighter. That is exactly what God does. And I want to tell you that there are some prayers that you just need a prophetic unction to come upon. God answers everybody's prayer, but there are some people that are God's favorite, whether you like it, but even little human being family, you see it at times. Even though sometimes parents try not to show it, but somehow, sometimes there are preferences. God, He has created us in His image. He has some like that. People that are in solid relationship with Him, number one, and that are having great responsibilities in His backyard. Combined, some people have one of the two. But the one that is so powerful that God honors their work, relationship with Him, high responsibilities with Him. When somebody is in a particular company, you know, the MD or the MDCO, they are responsible. You cannot come that, okay, I am in this, I've entered this, you just entered the reception. You are not working there. So they don't have to pay you salary when the month ends, when you are sick, or they don't need to take care of your hospital bill. Why? Because you are not, there is no responsibility. And whenever you need the audience of, that's why sometimes some people will be in the reception, with the reception waiting for somebody working there. You just say, I'll see you later. And you just walk in. Somebody is there, but I'm sitting there. No, he's working there. I want to go and attend to you. I need you. And through that, you will get some things done. I'm praying for you that the prayers that you have not been able to get answered, that required a prophet or a man of God, in the little office that God has put me, I pray for you. According to the will of God concerning that request, let it be quickly granted. In the name of Jesus. Anna has been praying for many years. 1 Samuel 1:17. She has been praying, and she prayed one particular time. And the man of God said, who are you? You must be a drunkard. I said, no, I'm not a drunkard. What are you asking God? He said, whatever you are asking God, let God grant you. And Eli answered and said, go in peace. And the God of Israel granted thee thy petition that thou asked of him. And that was it. In verse 20, just 3 verses after this one, Anna received visitation. In fact, she was already expectant, because the Bible said that she was not eating before, she started going to eat. Therefore, it came to pass, when the time was come, about after Anna had conceived, that she bare a son and called his name Samuel, saying, because I have asked him of the Lord. I'm saying to you again, whatever that thing that you have been asking God for, that you have not been receiving, as long as it is not against the will of God, let the Lord grant you with immediate effect. I said, let the Lord grant you with immediate effect. There are some people in life that you need to ride on their shoulder to get some things up. It's not because they are better than you. It's just because that person may not have access that you may not have. Somebody that lives in a particular place, or works in a particular place, or worships in a particular place, you say, somebody is, I want to sit. Come, follow me. And that's how the person will get access. There is this story of American president, Abraham Lincoln. In his time, they actually said that he happened to be very generous. So people love to go to him for issues that the superiors, they have been hammering them, knowing that once they will get to him, he always has compassion. And some of the leaders used to complain because he will not allow them to do something that he wanted to do. So one particular day, one congressman wanted to go for a business there, and when he got to White House, as usual, he saw many crowds. It was a usual scene in his own time, seeing crowds. Maybe you will just look at me and say, hey, what's the problem? The crowd. And before they went there, you know, he happened to be a congressman to do business and appointment with him. And he saw one old man at a corner, weeping, crying. And, you know, one of those things, it was that kind of sight was not too much unusual. That he went in, he did what he wanted to do, and went. The next day he came back for a repeat of what, or a follow-up. By the time he got there, he saw this man still in the corner, weeping and crying. I now went to him. Said, sir, what's the matter? Said that his son happened to be in the army of General Butler. That happened to be the general, the one in command in that time of Abraham Lincoln. And he said that he had been court martialed because he committed an offense, a crime, that he had to be court martialed and will be shot the next week. That has been proven to be the, I don't know what offense that he did. Said that that is why I don't want to see the president. He said that he has been court martialed, he has been already, that one is already, and the offense happened to be, said, why didn't you go to the head there so that they can help? Said that the head said, based on what he has done, there is nothing that he will not be able to do anything. So I said, is it okay? You know what? Let me finish the business that I have to do with here, then I will take you to Mr. Lincoln. You just follow me. And that was what happened. You now follow him. By the time President Lincoln saw him, he said that, my old friend, any problem? And he narrated the whole thing again. As I read, he said that on his face, he really felt sorrow concerning what had happened. And I said, but I may not be able to help you. Say why? Because I just received a telegram yesterday from General Volta saying that, sir, Mr. President, can you please keep your hand off all the things that happen in the ministry so that there will be discipline in the, because so I now read it to him. Said that, you see, I won't be able to do this. I said that, no, you have to do it. At the end of the day, when he kept on looking at him, he just said, okay, whatever it is, get me a sheet of paper. And he now wrote it. Said that, General Volta, I say that John so, the name of the man's son, should not be executed or something like that until an instruction from me, until an order from me, Abraham Lincoln. And I gave to him. The man was joyful, but when he read it, he said that until, I mean, that next week you could just change your mind. He said, no. Abraham Lincoln asked fine. He said that, you know me, homie. If you know me, you will know that if your son has long life to live, you will live as long as Methuselah with that note, because there will not be a time that I will change my mind. But this is just the promise, just give it to him like that. What are we saying? You know, this man could have been outside and they would have executed because he will not have opportunity to enter to see the president. But he rode on the back of another person that had access. I prophesy into your life that whatever you have desired in prayer, maybe you have written them down, you have asked God, the Almighty God, grant unto you. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You could be a prayer warrior. There are some things that your prayer cannot deliver unto you. You need the prophet over your life. There are some people that are falling in life because they have nobody above them. In Baker, many of them, they fell flat, and by the time they were falling, nobody. Everyone needs somebody that can speak into your life. Everyone. In the book of Acts chapter 10, 4 to 6, Cornelius, he was a prayer warrior, good man, good giver. But there was something he could not get. And when the angel appeared to him, The angel referred him to a man called Peter. Let me read it. And when he looked on him, he was afraid and said, "What is it, Lord?" And he said unto him, "Thy prayers and thy hands are what? Are come up for a memorial before God. And now, send men to Joppa, and come for who? One Simon, whose surname is Peter." 6. And he lodged with one Simon a tailor, whose house is by the sea side. He shall do what? Tell thee what thou ought to do. There are many portions of the scripture that I read for a long time. Later, the Holy Spirit will be giving me deeper understanding. Tell thee what thou oughtest to do. If you are talking to me, angel, that you tell me yourself, then no. There is an order in the realm of the spirit. If you refuse to submit yourself to the one that we have already assigned you and attached you to, you live like that and you never get that thing that he has been sent to deliver into your life. And by the time Peter, he eventually did that, you can see that your prayers have been heard, but part of your answer prayer is that there will be a man that will speak into your life and you will receive something that you are not able to receive. I think verse 44. I don't know. Is it verse 44? Verse 44 or something. When Peter was ministering unto them, I don't know where, if you do not get to verse 44, but somewhere down, as he was ministering, they were not receiving the Holy Spirit. Their prayer could not get them to receive that. Okay, why Peter here spake these words? The Holy Ghost fell on all them, which everyone, all the people, all the members of Cornelius' household. He had been praying, let them find your prayer in the hand and your hand, all these offering, the tithe, you have. But this thing will only be delivered unto you by a man agent that God has. But you are an angel now, you are even more spiritual than that. If you don't send for him, as I have just told you, you will not receive it. It's very important that we know that there are some things that we need higher authority to deliver into our life. Hosea chapter 12, verse 13. When God wanted to remove Israelites from the land of bondage, from their oppression, who did he use? And by a prophet, the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt. And by a prophet, what happened? Was he preserved? These are just telling you that there are some things that some people will not get until they locate who God has sent them to. I pray that the Almighty God will make it to the sense day. To whoever that prophet is in your own life. It does not really have to be us. But whoever that prophet is in your own life that God has actually sent to you, you will locate that person. Yeah. And that person will release the unction that the Almighty God has put in him or her unto you, and you get what you need to get in the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. So it's very important. For God, you know, the thing is God that answers prayer. You need to ride on the prophetic leverage. It asks a person to get what normally, you know, Saul, the answers of the father were missing. He kept on struggling, and then to be in 1 Samuel chapter 9, 20 or 26 or so. They were looking for the answers, they could not get it anyway. But by the time they encountered Samuel, after he told them that so that the answers will be found, don't worry. And by the time they got them, it has been found. Those people will be thinking that they just found it. See the answers that we have been looking for. We have checked this place, so we did not see it. They did not know that it's the power of God ordained prophet that actually brought that unto pass. There was a particular time. But he was going on a voyage, very dangerous voyage. the water, the storm that was sliding. Just like our father in the Lord has told us about storm. But some people, they don't really go on water, so they don't understand some things. They know what they call deep IC. When you get to the IC, you will look to the right. You will not see house or but there was one time that I went to one place and I went on the boat. You know, I not know this even covered boat. But what do you mean? I did not see anybody. The jacket that was there, one somebody that was sitting with me, I said, relax, relax, because I was only with you. I'm relaxed. Believe me, I was like, this is my own. This is not the Abu. Praise the Lord. So on the IC, it was there, and the water will carry the ship. You know, a ship is bigger than this. Out time 20, and it will be when there is serious storm. That like that kind of out times 20, it will be flinging it off like no toy of a little boy, flinging it off, landing again. The people said that they hated life, they thought that they were going to die, and for 3 days there was no storm, everything. And the prophet Paul said that nobody will lose his life in this ship. But the ship will be destroyed. But how does that happen? The ship will be destroyed, but nobody will die. Do you know that God honored that one? A book of Acts chapter 27, 18 to 22. Acts 27, 18 to 22. And we being exceedingly tossed with the tempest, the next day they lightened the ship. And the third day, we cast out with our own hands the tackling of the ship. And when neither sun nor star, imagine for you to explain the whole day, you know, you see some dark, a whole day, you don't know which one is day, which one is night. Neither sun nor star in many days appeared, and no small tempest lay on us, all hope that we should be saved was then taken away. That's one. But after long abstinence, Paul stood forth in the midst of them and said, "Sirs, ye shall have hearkened unto me, and not have loosed from Crete," because you are ready to learn earlier when you wanted to say that, "Let's not start the journey now." Said, "Are you a captain? Are you being the business of?" They did not understand because everything seemed clear. But the prophet has said that acting unto me and not have loosed from Crete and to have gained this arm and loss. 22. And now I exhort you to be of what? In that situation, be of good cheer. For there shall be no what? Loss of any man's life among you, but of. Verse 44. Can you give me 44? And the rest, some on the boat. After a while, when the thing scattered, the whole ship scattered, some people found themselves on the scatter board, and the thing now was flowing to the bank. All of them, as they did not even understand. And the rest, some on the boat, and some on broken pieces of the ship. And so it came to pass that they were. I prophesy into your life. Regardless of the things that this year, you and your family will be saved. Yeah. Regardless of the people that have been demoted, wherever you function, you will be promoted. Yeah. Regardless of what has happened before now in your life, you are going up. Yeah. There's somebody here, you have been cheated out of your possession. Before April, it shall be fully delivered. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. So it is very important that we ride on the prophetic leverage. There was a particular time that very early in the morning I was preparing to come to church. I think I was about to take my bath, and I received a call from a brother. The wife, I think that was the due date to deliver. And that wife had been coming to the office. When it was about 1 month to ED, she started coming and she said, "Pastor, I want you to pray. I want this time around to be better than the previous ones that I had. Okay, no problem, you're coming once in a while, but you're not coming every time, you should not be coming. I said, no problem. We just pay for 30 seconds, she will go. So on this particular Sunday, she called. He called. When he called, I was hearing her groaning on the, in the background. Then at the end of the day, I was saying, okay, I told him, let me pray for her. As I was praying, he was saying, all of a sudden, I heard that she started the phone for him. I need the water, you know. And he said, Pastor, continue praying. He said, but before you pray, I want you to pray that this one will be the fastest. That I'll be there and you're still growing, and you're saying, I said, okay, let it be the fastest for you. Let God settle you quickly in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said, amen. Then he called the phone. About 20 minutes, 15 to 20 minutes after, the other man called me. I said, what happened? He said, she had put to bed. I said, ah, glory to be to God. He said, but we ain't seeing the car. I said, I told you people are in your thing when you are calling me. That's why I pray that you see it just happen like that. How did it happen? Say that it's in my hand. You can't show me in my hand. Wow. Say that, in fact, I am talking to you, I don't even know, but we have told the person to carry on to turn back that we have one loss in our clothes. Stay on 27th Avenue. And that was how he did it. The people were still waiting for them in the hospital. They are carrying all their properties and the baby's home today. When he eventually went later, the guy said, where is your wife? We didn't even say, he was saying that, to collect my money. And prophesy into your life. Whatever you have taken unnecessary long time in your life to achieve, let the Almighty God cut short unnecessary. In the name of Jesus. There are some things that come to you. There was a particular sister that called up. Sometimes she was in the hospital. She said that my younger sister, that sister traveled out now. She's in South Africa. She has been in the hospital. She has been admitted. They, I think, looked or something. That they have tested, they ran all tests, nothing. And she was growing worse and worse. And I said, okay, no problem, let's pray. We just pray. I remember the way we prayed that God just came to that control. Then about an hour and a half later or something like that, she called. When I was saying, ah, my heart was busy, I said, I hope you will not go and tell me something. Say, yes, it was with the devil. Say, Pastor, I cannot believe it. I said, what happened? You know that they came around again and they said that, ah, the prophet is not, there's no need for you to say, you are discharged. Somebody that 2 hours before, they said that they did not even know. Out of a sign, whatever sickness anybody may be carrying, let that sickness be out of your life.
Amen.
I said, let that sickness be out of your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It's very important that he gave them the bread, but he knew that he had empowered them, and the bread was being multiplied in their hands. It is very important. In the book of 2 Chronicles 20:20. So that you need to believe God. But God now also informed us that it's not only God. And they rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Joshua stood and said, hear me, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe who? In the Lord your God. So shall ye be established. Believe again. His prophet, so shall you prosper. People, there are some people, they don't want to take this for chance, for granted. They pray, they drink, they fast, they use every means that they know that so that nothing will escape. If the rod of this one is escaping, the rod of Elijah will not escape and everything will be taken. This year you will not miss any blessing. That God has designed for you, you shall get up.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There is power in prophetic leverage, meaning what normally you may not deserve. By the reason of the relationship that somebody else has with God, or the credit the person has with God, by working for him, you will just be granted it.
Amen.
There was a particular time, a king was issued a death sentence by God. Guess what happened? Did that into Abraham's wife? God now advised that king. Said, you know what? I've already issued it that you will die. But for you not to die, in fact, not only you, every member of your house, go to my prophets. If he prays for you, I will honor his prayer. Wow. There are some things I read in the scriptures, it gives me deeper understanding of how God regards some things that some people be cheaping, and they are not getting the result that they want to get. In the book of Genesis 23, God gave what's the name of this king again? And God came to Abimelech here in a ring by night and said to him, behold, what did he say? That, if God is telling somebody that somebody is there, what again? For the woman which thou hast taken, for she is a man's wife. Can you go to 7? 7. Go to 7. Let's see what God advises. Now, therefore, he saw the man his wife. For he what? That's when I learned you. Okay. He's a prophet. Abraham wanted to be a prophet in those sites. And he shall pray for thee, and thou shalt live. And if thou restore her not, know that thou shalt surely die. Thou and all that are thine. He said that he should go to his prophet. He shall pray for him. There are some things that prophetic leverage can give you. There's a particular sister, I think a year ago, the thing happened, and sometimes I look at, I remember the thing, and her mind is back. She traveled out, and she happened to be coming to this parish, but on part-time basis. Part-time basis means that she was attending another place, but she was, but after a while, she was not really there, and not really here, but every special program, she was there, and later she was increasing more than special program to a normal program. And within that, she said, I'm not to join this church or not to join this church. And he said, well, I have my own mission that I go now, you know. And I know this is, I know, she has come to her. I said, I go to her. I was like, ah, no problem, everywhere that God, everywhere God is, you got to leave me anywhere, no problem. And so she traveled. And she traveled for some time. She said, she had a very clear, serious revelation. In that revelation, she saw that she was looking for a prophet. I think the one in charge of the entire mission that she was operating under. And she now heard the voice. She said, why are you looking for a prophet? Pastor Tokumbosubu Luluwa is your prophet. That time, I just changed my name. You know, I changed my name April something 2 years ago. I said, God see, accredited my change name. And the person that called me that afternoon, things was in the morning over there. Said, Apostle, me said, what happened? He said, I had a dream that the thing has been coming to my heart, but it just confirmed. I said, what happened? He now told me the thing. Within me, I said, me? God will be showing somebody. Am I the prophet like that? You know? I was saying that, you didn't know what for today, what for the one who wants to do before I see. You know, I didn't say this to her. But I said, said that, God said that, my passport to Kumo, she is from the East, so the pronunciation of my name, said that, she mentioned my name. I said, wow. I was happy one way that God honored us somehow in our little corner, but I was also scared that I should be careful or anything, you know, the people that are following, their own staff, when they tell God to give staff, their own staff is usually like that. So, I don't know, it was in mixed version. But what they are saying is that in whatever little thing that God has given unto us, we are prophesying into your life. This year shall be your best year. That's a particular sister. She told, that, I think it was last year that she told, she came to, I think she came to she came to the office and she said that she has been given one assignment to do. So to talk to high caliber people in a particular assignment she was giving, that anytime she was giving any big assignment like that, that sometimes she will receive, or something will just happen that opportunity will go, and she came that we should pray. We prayed. Then on the morning she was to go, she called me very early in the morning. And she said, Pastor, I started feeding someone. I said, no problem. It is well. Then we just, I can't remember how we prayed. She went. Then later, when she called in the afternoon, she was just excited. She said that there are big people that she could not even stand one-on-one, that she had to go and deliver, whether it's a lecture or something, to them, that all of them started giving her ovation. She said she knew that she was not the one, that it was God. That's why I'm telling somebody, any competition you'll be going from today, or any kind of thing that you need to be, to deliver anything, the Almighty God will help you.
Amen.
Beyond your ability, God will deliver results to you.
Amen.
I said, beyond your ability, God will deliver results to you. When you write on the prophetic leverage, difficult things becoming. There was a particular centurion in the book of Matthew chapter 8. He was telling the man of God. That happened to be Jesus Christ that time. You don't need to come to my house. Why are you coming? Just speak the word. Because you are a prophet of God. As they saw him that time, of course he was a prophet, he was everything together. He said, just speak the word. And at that same moment, that issue will be resolved. And Jesus Christ said, wow. Many people don't really, they know many things spiritually about Bible, but they don't normally get to know this prophetic leverage. But because you have done that, say that, let it be unto you. And the centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worried that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. 13. Let's just go to the end of the matter. And Jesus said unto the centurion, go thy way, and as thou hast believed, so be it done unto what? And what happened? And his servant was healed. When? The next day. This same hour, anyone that is sick, receive the vital. This same hour, anyone that is monetarily challenged, receive divine solution. This same hour, anyone that has been struggling under any cause or any covenant that you inherited, let it be divinely broken. This same hour, anyone that is any other disciples of Jesus that ought to deliver something to you, good thing, that have not remembered you, let that person remember you. Your years that you have lost, no matter how long, whether 25 years you have lost, 30 years you have lost, or 7 years you have lost, recover all. So shall it be.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
One thing about prophetic leverage is that it depends on the faith of the receiver. A seed may be good, but the soil is also a determining factor on how fruitful the harvest will be. That's why Jesus Christ was giving the disciple a graphical illustration about seed sowing and the different types of harvest. The same quality of seed in the book of Mark chapter 4, 3 to 8, you see there. Mark 4, 3 to 8. There are some, they don't believe. No problem. You don't have to believe. We don't beg people to believe. If God has not opened your eyes, you will not believe. You are going to realize in this life that I don't struggle. Did anybody believe, right? Please do not believe, right? But we are seeing the results. People are getting testimony. If you don't believe, keep yourself forth. And also, even if you believe, it's to the measure of the belief. So you need the Holy Spirit to impress on your heart that somebody is really for him and somebody is not for him, so that it will help you to release yourself in receiving from that vessel. Aki, behold, there went out a sower to sow. And it came to pass, as he sowed, some fell by the wayside, and the fowl of the air came and devoured it up. And some fell on stony ground. When they are talking about this ground, they are people's hearts. So what is he saying? And this won't be a prophet, no problem. Fell on stony ground, where it had not much earth. And immediately he sprang up, because it had no depth of earth. But when the sun was up, it was scorched, and because it had no root, it was withered away. So, and some fell on thorns, and the thorns grew up and what? Choked it, and it yielded what? No fruit. Then the last one. And others fell on good ground. This one they believe, but their level of belief differ. Some believe, I believe small. I believe a little bit small. So, I totally believe everything. And did yield fruit that sprang up and increased and brought forth some 30 and some 60 and some what? 100. I prophesy to your life, don't worry, to receive 100. And Jesus was telling the disciples, when they did not understand, which one you see so, I said, you still don't understand? He now said in Mark chapter 4, 14, Mark 4, he said that the seed is the word. The word that comes forth. He said that the other people may not understand, but let me explain it to you. This is my key disciple, is the word. Words are received by people. I spoke in the name of Jesus. I said, amen. And somebody made 30 for amen. And now I'm sitting for amen. With the pen, see that the sower, sower, see that this Bible that I just told you is just the word that goes forth. Because the Bible says that when there is an anointed of God that is speaking the word ceases to be ordinary. They are all spirit and life. Which means that any death situation, and the word said, I decree, let there be a change in that situation. Life entered into that dead Lazarus, and Lazarus comes forth, and testimony will now come. It's very important that we understand. There was a particular sister that came to us. Our elder sister used to attend this church before relocating, and she came for holiday with her. And she brought, the other sister brought her, because she came to the office concerning her business, but the sister came, she introduced the sister, ah, this is my younger sister, and everything, let me know, but I want, she now told us that she had never received, you know, serious proposal. Maybe what she meant is that, not that she had, yeah, serious proposal since she was born up to now. That will be all this, you know, but serious one, that, you know, she will be staying for, I think, 2 weeks, when she was on holiday, at place of work. So, okay, I gave her some prayer points that God laid in my heart to give to her. Then, on the, we told her to do some things, prayers and fasting. Then she came, when we anointed her, and she prayed. I did not see her again. But I think she now resumed. I forgot about it. Then about 6 or 7 months later, I received a mail, because I think it was through my email avenue that I used to send the prayers to her, I can't remember. So she had my email address, and she now wrote me. And she was not, then she was, I was the million she was writing me. And she wrote me. And she wrote me. And the thing that she said there, dear pastor, I'm sorry, I also have not come to you. Many things have happened just this month. And they are just reading through, you know. Anyway, but right now, I'm having my honeymoon outside the country. My ego is not swelling again. You believe me? And I now felt this kind of thing. Oh wow, I'm happy for her. No, because what she, I was saying that it's not, and you have to be younger to the best I even brought, but that one came for business matter, but she came for my matter. But all your matter, let your life go through. All your matter, let your life go through. Right on prophetic level. These things are reality. I've heard of Bishop Edebu one time. I was having crisis. Everything was just not, just call his father, the one that I call his father, our father-in-law. That he had three of them that time. I think Idaosa too was one of them. Another person outside. I was just calling them, that please speak your, speak the word. Say what happened. I think one of the children happened to be terribly sick. And one of them, you would have not even told them, say that, that child shall not die. He just said, he knew that was it. And up to tomorrow, that child is still alive. There are some people that they understand the power of prophecy. He is not even ashamed with how big God has blessed him, and I love him so much. I've gained so many things from him. He'll keep saying, calling Pastor Iya Adeboye, that God, he said that he did not even know him before. That when he wanted to start ministry, he said that send for my servant Adeboye and let him lay hand on you and anoint you. And that was what exactly he did. Of course, he's making waves all over the world. But he said something that regularly you see good days for freshness of function. For fun. Those people, they understand spiritual things. Some people, you cannot be, you cannot do everything by yourself. You need sometimes prophetic, you need to ride on the wing of prophetic move or leverage to get some things done. Many times, you just require just a little push and it shall be done. So it depends on you. Depends on your level of belief. Because Jesus was telling him that according to your belief, let it be unto you. If you don't believe, no matter the anointing of that anointed man, it does not work. In the book of Matthew chapter 13, I think 54 to 58, Matthew, the whole Jesus fight, he went to his own hometown. Jesus Christ, the man anointed. And what is he saying? And he was coming to his own country. He touched them in their synagogue. In so much that they were astonished. And said, where has this man, this wisdom, and this mighty work? So they are even seeing the wisdom that he was with. I was not wondering, hey, if you now acknowledge this, then what's the problem? Go on, if you see it. Is not this the carpenter's son? Is not his mother called Mary, and his brother James and Joseph and Simon and Judas? 56. And his sisters, are they not all with us? When then are this man all these things? And they were offended in him. But Jesus said unto them, a prophet is not without honor, save in his own country and his own house. 58. A sorry verse. And he did not many what? Mighty works there. Ah, why? Because of their unbelief. Everybody is not your prophet. I don't have to be your prophet, but be sensitive to who God has ordained over your life. Once you ride over their prophetic leverage, when your colleagues, they are going at the 30-fold level of blessing, you'll be getting 100-fold. I'm not praying, I'm just telling you, that's why I've taken time to open different parts of the scripture. There are some dangers that are battered because you have a covering. I told you some great men of God, they're greater. And some other guy, the first flat, they had no coverage. Don't allow that to be. Lot and his family could have all died. But for Abraham, in the book of Genesis 18, Genesis 18, don't know, 18, verse, I don't know, when they started the negotiation, but from 30, maybe 32 or something, God said something very early in that. And I will be doing something. I want to go and destroy Sodom and Gomorrah. And I know Lot, who happened to be Abraham's nephew, lived there. Let me tell you. And actually, he told him. And which one is this one? Okay. I was still going to this. He told him. And he told him that he was about to go to destroy. Then Abraham said, prayer session started. What if there are 50 people there? When you read that, that is what they call prayer intercession, interceding for somebody, bringing somebody's matter. God, this person is sick, he's here. Or this person is required in that intercession or the prophet. And God said, well, for 50 people, I will not. What of 45? What of 40? Okay, God, please have mercy. What of 30? What of 20? And he now went down to, can you go down to that 32? Let's see whether it's 32. And he said, oh, let not the Lord be angry, and I will speak yet but this one. Peradventure, ten shall be found there. And he said, I will not destroy it for 10's sake. 33. And the Lord went his way. As soon as he had left from me, imagine that relationship that he had. That Lot, we were not told that he even had that. So it was because of somebody that he had over him that made him to escape that danger. With Abraham, and Abraham returned unto his place. When he now, you know, eventually God did not see 10 people. For God, if I should destroy, it will pain Abraham. Our relationship, say, God, and I was begging because of you. No, even I didn't say, because, okay, angel, I'm destroying this. Go and remove this family. In Genesis 19, 1929, Bible said that because of Abraham, Genesis 19, 29, I get back. When God destroyed the city of the plague, that God remember who?
Abraham.
Abraham! And what did he now do? And sent Lot out of the midst of the overthrow. When he overthrew the cities in the which Lot dwelt, there are many people, they never knew that something could have happened to them. But for their cup, he never even knew. There are some people, there are some danger that they are, if not that they have a covering, they will have been cut off. And some people, they share testimony, they say, I know you people, they don't know that it's not just, everything you see is not always about you, it's about who is above you. At times, that is why we need to take this leverage, so that by the end of this year, we'll look that, wow, this has been the best year so far. And I prophesy into your life. Everything that you have missed since you were born, that ought to be in your life. I don't care how it will run, Almighty God, let that be supernatural release.
Yeah.
If time has to be won back for anybody to achieve something, let it be so.
Yeah.
If the working of your body has to be renewed for you to receive something that you need to get at this your stage of your life, receive that in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I prophesy to your life, whatever the experts have said no to, that is supposed to be in your life for you to rejoice, let that no be canceled.
Yeah.
Let the Almighty God deliver
you. Yeah.
So shall it be.
Yeah.
Before we ask to pray, I remember the story of one of our brothers here. He came to us one time. He said, Pastor, one particular person is frustrating me in one complaint. And I have submitted just for them to pay me. I've done everything that I have to do. You know, he was running a particular service for them, or a particular service for them. They have done everything. And the person said, he kept on pushing my thing aside. I just cried. I said, maybe she wants to lose her job. Or she wants to be removed there. He now smiled. And I said, maybe I'll rest straight. Did I issue the decree that let the Almighty God step into the situation? But if the person remains Adama, let something negative take the person out. He came the next day. He said, Pastor, that same day, I receive a call. Please come and collect it. Come and collect your things. Don't kill me. Everyone that is holding on to something, your fear, the Almighty God will appear to them. I just begin to bless the name of the Lord. I'm going to be praying some prayers here that God has helped us to put out. Open your mouth and just give thanks to Him. Give thanks to Him. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. You are saying, Father, thank you for the opportunity of your representative to prophesy into my life. God, give thanks for that. When you thank God, God will do that. Okay, you understand. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Amen. Father, anything in my life and destiny that will repel good prophecies or prevent it from coming to pass, in your mercy, come out of my life in the name of Jesus. Anything in my life that will repel good prophecies, come out of my life. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, you said in the scripture that as long as you live, that what is spoken in your ears, you will do. You know one thing that I forgot to tell you? You are the first prophet of your life. Which means that once you decree a thing, it has come to pass. Say, therefore.
I decree,
it shall be well with me.
It shall be well with
my family. The remaining days of this year shall be my best days. Everywhere I go,
I shall meet with favor.
No matter how many people contesting for any good thing that I'm contesting for, I shall be most highly favored. The economic situation in this nation or anywhere I find myself, I will keep on getting better, getting richer. Through me, God will bring salvation to multitudes.
Through me,
the homeless shall receive shelter.
Through me,
the poor shall be made rich.
Shall be made strong.
Different occasion for people to frightly congratulate me shall occur throughout this year. I will be exceedingly great in this life. My best season in all areas of my life has just started today. The thing that have hurt me before will turn around to help me graciously.
I shall not die.
But live.
To
declare the goodness of God in the land of the living. All the good things I've been looking for and chasing after will start looking for me. I shall live in divine health and operate with divine wisdom. All my enemies will be forever falling aside.
Anyone that despises me
will come back and bow to me. I shall enjoy the best things of God that you have provided in this life. All believers shall seek to know my God because of the good reason.
my heavenly Father shall increase them. All my prayer requests shall speedily become sweet testimony. The Most High God of heaven and earth shall marvelous help me in all that I do. I and my family shall make every glorious thing.
I will see
in the fullness of our time. Now let me release this prophetic unto you. And God will say amen as you receive it. You shall not sorrow over any of your loved ones in negative. Anyone that says that you will not make progress in any area of your life shall die. Your season of laughter and divine compensation for all delays and denial has started to come. You will never lack any good in your life again. All your enemies shall crumble and fall before you by the blessings that will make you a celebrity in your generation shall flow into your life. International doors of great nature be open unto you. Let international wealth of many nations flow into your country. Sickness and frustration shall be stranger in your life and your family. And keep an handle. You shall be worthy to be.